brisk polling reported in 57 seats of the fifth and final phase of Bihar Assembly polls. Over 20% polling reported till 12 noon, counting in result on Sunday. Prime Minister Narendra Modi launches four gold-related schemes. The flagship gold monetization scheme replaces the existing gold deposit scheme. PM also launches India gold coin-bearing Ashok Chakra and gold sovereign bond scheme. President launches Imprint India, a 1,000 crore project to kickstart original research in areas where the country is dependent on foreign technology. Prime Minister Narendra Modi hands over the first copy to the president. PM says that the biggest strength of Make in India is human capital and the skill development is extremely vital. The third leg of Vice President Hamid Ansari's Jakarta, Bali, Brunei trip is likely to be cancelled after a volcanic eruption forced the suspension of air travel in the isle till Friday morning. Vice President was to leave to Brunei on a first-of-its-kind bilateral visit on Wednesday afternoon, where he was to meet Sultan of Brunei. Deportation of gangster Chota Rajan delayed further as flight operations from Bali Airport remain suspended due to volcanic ash. All formalities completed for the deportation. The 55-year-old gangster is facing as many as 75 cases of serious nature like murder, extortion and kidnapping. He was arrested on October 26 by Indonesian authorities on a tip-off given by the Australian police and Indian agencies. Prime Minister Modi's ranking improved 6 places as he is now the 9th most powerful leader as per the list prepared by Forbes magazine. Russian President Putin continues to top the list. Forbes said PM Modi presided over 7.4% GDP growth in his first year in office and raised his profile as a global leader during the official visits with Barack Obama and Xi Jinping. Justice T.S. Thakur to be the next Chief Justice of India to assume office from the present Chief Justice, Justice H.L. Dattu, on December 2. Justice Thakur, who would be the 43rd CJI for the Supreme Court, will have a tenure of 1 year and 1 month and serve till January 3, 2017. Union Minister of State for Information and Broadcasting, Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore, has said that the coverage of private FM channels in the country will be expanded to 65% in the next 2 years. From the current levels of 42%. The minister also informed that the government is planning to set up campus of Indian Institute of Mass Communication, IIMC, at Jaipur. Pawan Hans helicopter crashes off the coast of Mumbai. 2 pilots reported missing. No passenger on board the ill-fated helicopter. The chopper was carrying out night landing practice with only 2 pilots on board when it crashed and sank. A fresh spell of snowfall in high-altitude tribal and other areas of Himachal has blocked the Mari Rohtang road, as several tourists and vehicles were stranded in the region. Some tourists who had gone to Rohtang Pass were stranded between Mari and Rohtang, but rescue teams were dispatched immediately as they were brought to Manali. Harjeet Sajjan, an Indo-Canadian Sikh, was named Canada's new defence minister. Harjeet Sajjan is elected as a MP for Vancouver South. He is a combat veteran and has served in Bosnia and had 3 deployments to Kandahar, Afghanistan. India has expressed concern over the lack of political progress in Nepal but promised to continue to extend all assistance to the Himalayan nation for its peace, stability and socio-economic development. India made the statement at 2nd Universal Periodic Review, UPR, part of the interactive dialogue at the 23rd session of the UPR Working Group at the office of the UN High Commissioner for Refugees in Geneva. A rise in US interest rates in December is a life possibility, Janet Yellen, chair of the Federal Reserve, has told a congressional committee. The US Central Bank holds a policy meeting in December at which it could decide on a long-anticipated increase in interest rates. US interest rates have been near zero since December 2008. The United States and Britain has said a bomb may have brought down a Russian airliner which crashed in Egypt, as the Islamic State group insisted it caused the disaster. If confirmed, it would be the first ever Islamic State bomb attack on passenger plane. Both Russia and Egypt have raised doubts over the claim of responsibility by the IS. But officials say they cannot rule out anything and the investigation of the black boxes may take few weeks or even months. Russian Airbus crashed in the Sinai Peninsula, killing all 224 people on board. Team India wins toss and decides to bat first against South Africa in the first test being played in Mohali. Rohit Sharma left out from the playing 11. Varun Aaron and Ravindra Jadeja included. Captain Virat Kohli hoping for a good innings on his birthday.